Talk to me a little bit about your work with Wicked Bros, right? Why did you start it? Who is it for? And how do you choose the artists that you work with?
So, who is it for? Wicked Bros, the organization is. It's a very tough question. What do you mean by who is it for?
Who are you
It's
helping?
who we were helping. We are basically, I would say, sitting and trying to weave together an ecosystem.
Okay.
Because, as I pointed out in the beginning, it's a very unorganized sector. Like, even for me to understand how many art residencies we have in India right now, no idea. Like, I know
Right.
five, six probably, but
Okay.
the average artist doesn't know five, six also. So that's the thing, to create a community of artists and provide them employment or opportunities in terms of, like, just CSR opportunities or getting them to collaborate or as I pointed out, like getting illustrators out on the streets as much as possible,
Right.
doing the Ladies First Festival to try and get the female artists out on the street as much as possible, getting and the second thing is to make the corporates and the governments and the peoples kind of also accept this along the way
Right.
and to service them first of all through the commercial piece that we can
Okay.
do or using cost-based NGO projects. Like, for example, we are doing this project in Gauthan in Marol right now in Andheri East,
Right.
where it's a 200-year-old establishment in Marol of East Indian Anglo-Indians, and the government has BMC has classified that as a slum area.
Okay.
So we are now painting over there and just, like, reviving some of their memories and culture onto the walls. So that is something that we are doing. So that's the idea, to weave together this architecture of the ecosystem, in which, by
Right.
the way, your art residencies, so we have art residencies in our community. We have
Okay.
artists, obviously. We have also all our clients, governments, NGOs involved. We helped the Waste Warrior NGO over there so many times. We've done projects with them, and the paint companies. We're working with paint companies, spray can
Right.
companies, Camlin, Fevicryl,
So
many of them.
do you approach artists or do the artists approach you when they want to be a part of the ecosystem that you're trying to build?
It's both ways. I mean,
Okay.
depends who comes in contact with whom. So that's what it is. And it all started off with not as this in mind, honestly. We didn't think it
Right.
was this complex. We didn't think we'd
Okay.
wanted to kind of wade into it so deep.
What did you set out to
But
do initially?
initially, it was just like some kind of a fun project. Like, everything starts. मेरे को आर्ट करने का है तो चलो आर्ट से लेट्स ट्राई एंड मेक आर्ट एज अ करियर एंड वी ट्राई टू डू दैट इनिशियली एंड वी वर सेलिंग बॉटल्स पेंटेड एंड वी वर सेलिंग टी शर्ट्स एंड कोस्टर्स पेंटेड एंड स्टफ एंड एवरीथिंग अंडर द रूफ लाइक वी वर दिस
Right.
कलेक्टिव सो दैट्स व्हेन वी यूज्ड टू यूज द वर्ड कलेक्टिव बाय द वे
Okay.
बिकॉज इट वॉज ट्रूली अ कलेक्टिव एज सच ऑफ जस्ट हैंडफुल ऑफ फ्रेंड्स वी ऑल न्यू But soon we realized so many flaws in that system. Like, people
Okay.
wouldn't know what to make. There's a branding problem. There's an organization problem. And so we kind of charted our own way through. And now we are knee deep in the graffiti street art movement, where we're trying to weave, as I said, this ecosystem together with all the organizations and artists as well.
Awesome. I'm really excited to see where this whole movement is going to go because I'm already seeing a lot of beautiful work out there, in person and on the internet. And it's really
Yes.
cool that you're part of it, and I'm definitely going to be following up on your work. But before we end this, I have to ask, can you tell us about the police incident where you had to go to the cops? Because I just want people out there to know what they can expect when they get up to this.
That was kind of unfortunate, and I hope never to repeat it. But
All right.
as I said, like, I do hang out with the graffiti artist. I'm not exactly the guy who would expect to be doing graffiti because I teach digital marketing. I'm
Sure.
working with all these corporates and working out strategies with them. So you can imagine this whole 9 to 5 kind of entrepreneur or a
Right.
cool stuff. But I used to sketch, and I have this and I still do Photoshop designs for all my clients and stuff. So there's obviously this creative side which gets fulfilled through Wicked Bros. And for one of our projects, we went to a smart city for a
Okay.
street art fest. I was invited there as a curator, by the way, to kind
Okay.
of to organize the fest, and I had 2-3 days of time to kill before the fest would begin and the artists started arriving. So I was in my hotel room, and one day I just went to the Smart City office and came back. And I did not realize this, but while coming back, and by the way, that was the time when I would just carry a spray can across to kind of get my hands onto the spray can and get that feel of it, because, you know, at some level, I was inspired truly by the graffiti tagging scene.
Right.
So I was tagging a wall, and what happened was the next day. So I tagged it. I went home. I went to the hotel room. Next day at the Smart City office, while going to the Smart City office, I got a call from my hotel guy. He's like, "Sir, can you please come back to the room because your tap is open." I'm like, "I did not open my tap."
The tap is open.
Yeah, my bathroom water tap was open. I was like, "No, they didn't." So I told him, "Okay, I have some work. You can take the keys from me." And so I reached the Smart City office, and at that point, he also arrives. And with him, a couple of cops arrived, and they're like, "Please come with us." I was like, "Kya ho gaya?" So they did not explain to me. So they take me to the police station, and I'm sitting over there, and nobody is helping me out. I'm like completely confused. Why have they got me here? And I'm just sitting over there, and they've taken away my phone and stuff. So I'm sitting. After some time, somebody comes in shouting, "Arey, how can they do this? How can they do this?" And then I'm like, "Kya ho gaya hai, pata nahi." So finally they reveal that somebody has tagged a wall in a Islamic font.
Okay.
Like, that's what I do. I write my name as Maktub on the wall.
All right.
In an Arabic font. And people over there could not understand what is this. You know, it's not even English.
Right.
So they kind of got scared.
Okay.
And it was election season. So people were like, "This is some terrorist threat which is happening." And, you know, people started interpreting it in very different, wrong ways.
Right.
So just behind my back, all this happened, and the cops got me over there. And then finally, I had to make a call to the Smart City CEO to explain to him, "Boss, this is the situation."
Right.
And so he had to come there, and it was very, very embarrassing with him next to me and looking at the footage, because I did not notice it, by the way, but the house on which I tagged belonged to the guy who was selling CCTVs in the entire city. So obviously he had his own house CCTV'd. So yeah, on the footage, I'm like, you know, like a graffiti artist with that hood. Tagging, and then the Smart City CEO is also asking, "Sir, ye kya kar rahe? What are you doing over here?" I'm like, "I can't explain you, but this is nothing. I don't mean any harm and stuff. And I'm an artist. Look at this, my portfolio. I'm doing this, that." Then they released me, but they were like completely. And the guy whose house it was, he came there. He was like, "I'll not leave this guy, this, that." So they had it whitewashed and all everything. Right. But that was kind of scary at that point.
So the problem that arises is the messaging, or the perceived messaging, as opposed to the actual tagging of a wall. Yeah.
Both of these things. That was like very, completely like, you know, new to them. Like, why would somebody tag a wall like this?
Right.
Like that too in the middle of the night, and that too with this Islamic font. Why would you do that? So there was a mixture of, it's a cocktail of like, it's the worst situation you want to be in, probably.
Yeah, I can imagine. But, you know, Zain, thank you so much for taking the time out to do this. It's been an absolute pleasure talking to you. And can you tell us, for all the artists out there who want to reach out to you and Wicked Bros, what is the best way to reach out to you?
The best way to reach out to us is on our website. There's an email ID which is given, which is sales@wickedbros.com.
Okay.
Or probably you can also WhatsApp me on 888-777-95823. I'll have you added to our Street Art United communities, which are present in Mumbai, Delhi, and Dehradun as of now. Or you can follow us on Instagram if you just want to see our work or just chat with us. You can also follow our projects, Ladies First Street Art or Marol Art Village, to also see what are the kind of stuff we are doing.
Awesome. Thank you so much for doing this, Zain. Have a good day.
Thank you so much, Parag. Thank you so much for having me, and best of luck to the rest of your podcast.
Awesome.
because this has been an absolutely, I completely loved the questions, by the way, like very well prepared and very well asked, spot on questions, which have kind of highlighted the scene in the right way. And I hope I've done justice representing the community. So look forward to seeing this on the web whenever. And yeah, look forward to also meeting you sometime in person.
Looking forward to it, Zane. Thanks again.
Yes.